This is Pinky, and you're listening to Agnes' story on Illuminate, Hands at Work in Africa's Advent series on the Meanwhile in Africa podcast channel. It's hot, hot and dusty. They call Malawi the warm heart of Africa. That's an understatement today. The sun is still climbing, and Agnes' mother sits looking into a washing tub as if she has a question to ask of it. The clothes drink up the water as fast as they are thrown in. They don't understand the work involved and how precious water is. The rains are late again this year. Unaware of the work that he's making for his mother, Agnes' younger brother is juggling some dust from one hand to the next, spilling it on his shorts with each pass. He looks across the path that winds between the houses and smiles at his neighbor's friend. A barefoot child who is stamping and kicking up the dust in his own yard. Between the mud brick thatch huts, you can see the mountains that serve as a reminder that there is something more out there beyond the community of Mpunzi. Agnes's mother hates the idea of what is beyond Mpunzi. A year ago, Agnes was only 14 and already had her eyes set beyond the community, beyond the care point and beyond her mother's washing tub. Sarah lives in South Africa but supports the Hands at Work team in Theta, Malawi.
Agnes lives in a community called Mpunzi, which is part of a larger community called Mchineka. We have a large CBO in Mchineka with a sub-feeding point in Mpunzi. Agnes is one of the 97 children who attends the Mpunzi care point.
At the care point, she knows that she is loved by local volunteer care workers, yet Agnes was always looking beyond. She wanted to see the city, to go and see Lilongwe, and to get work there as a domestic helper. Bertua, from Hands at Work team in Deta, shares how Agnes' mother recalls those days.
She was saying that she wanted to go to Lilongwe. So her mom was advising her. What the way you need to go to Lilongwe? So she was saying that I go and I start like a domestic work in Lilongwe. So her mom was saying that no, you need to continue to go to school. Because it's only when you finish your school, it's when you find a good job in Lilongwe. Not now. Now it's too early.
She didn't want to refuse her daughter that dream, but it would mean only trouble at this point. But Agnes was making a plan. When her mother was busy having her crop of maize ground for Nshima, Agnes grabbed her school bag and drew in a few items. Dan also supports the team in Malawi and has just returned from there.
She'd obviously picked up some really bad habits in the city because she then got involved with prostitution.
Her mother knew of a friend that Agnes ran away with and was able to contact the friend on her phone, and Agnes agreed to come home. Recently, she ran away again to a community called Salima.
And of course, we don't know the reason why they wanted to do this. She and a few friends went to the town of Salima, which is a few hours away.
The trauma from her previous disappearance still gripped Agnes's family, the care workers, the local Hands at Work team, as well as a broader team of support. Simon leads the Hands at Work team in Malawi, working alongside Bethwell.
One day, there are some disagreements between her and her friends, and she was beaten up. She was beaten up and she was taken to hospital, and later she was discharged and she continued with the same thing. And at the second time, she was also beaten. And it's when she called her mom saying, "Please, I want to come back. Will you please come and pick me?"
Her mother's heart was weary from despair. The thought of Agnes coming home gave a glimpse of hope. Agnes had been abused, but she was coming home. Agnes says,
"Yes, things have been tough here. It's hard. It's not fun. It's not easy. We're having to do things we don't want to do. We're being taken advantage of here. It's hard. It's hard to get food. It's hard to live like this. And I want to come home."
Early in the morning, Simon went along with her mother to fetch Agnes. It was a triumph.
Now we have come. So are you still thinking, going back home? And she said, yes, I'm willing to go back home because I'm tired being beaten with my friends. So I want to come back.
Agnes is a vulnerable girl.
So now that she's home, of course, she has some trauma that remains with her.
Bertel spoke to her mother.
So I was asking her that I heard that she's expecting. So she was saying that, yes, that's what also gave me stress. Because I'm thinking, you know, even during the night, I'm not sleeping because I'm still thinking.
They were bringing her back to the care point. But last Thursday, she took off, and no one knew this. We found this out today. She took off and they don't know where she is.
There is an African proverb that says, it takes a village to raise a child. It means that an entire community of people must interact with children for those children to experience and grow in a safe and healthy environment.
We went to Mpunzi care workers and we shared it with them, and they were, they were so pained for this. But again, they were like, we do not give up. We are not giving up on this girl. So, you know, they're trying to think through how they can find out where she is. And then they prayed.
Agnes's community includes her mother, the care workers of Mchineka, the local and African Hands at Work family, including Simon, Bertwell, Sarah and Dan. And of course, you. It is now a global village that can impact Agnes' life. Luke 2 verse 10 says, fear not, for behold, I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. And this Advent season, we hold out hope for Agnes.
And that's my hope, that God can rescue her from the pit, that God will transform her life and bring her back.
Join us with Agnes's mother in prayer.
I know she's still in the process, that God can see her and God can hear my cry.
Thank you for listening to Agnes's continuing story. Her name has been changed for her privacy. This has been Illuminate, Hands at Work Advent Podcast. Advent means coming. Our hope for girls like Agnes is in Jesus, the one who is, who was, and who will come again. If you haven't already subscribed to the podcast, please do on Spotify, Apple, or Google Podcasts. In the new year, we'll continue with weekly short stories about what God is busy doing on the ground in Africa. If you'd like to support financially, please visit www.handsatwork.org/give.